I'm Iahn Gonsenhauser, Chief Quality and Patient Safety Officer at The Ohio State University Wexner Medical Center. Winter is coming, and as we approach these cold winter months, here are my top three concerns about COVID right now. Number one, as the cold weather descends on us, we're all going to be spending more time indoors. And as we head indoors, our risk mitigation strategies for COVID-19 are going to change a little bit. We've learned that COVID-19 is spread through respiratory droplets and aerosols. And in the past few months, we've learned that those aerosols can linger indoors in poorly ventilated areas a bit longer than we previously thought. This means that precautions like social distancing and mask use are more important than ever. When the weather allows it, we should be spending as much time as we can outdoors. And all of us should be avoiding crowds in poorly ventilated spaces. Number two, the flu. Flu season is upon us, and with it come additional concerns and complications. Every year, influenza claims the lives of tens of thousands of Americans. It can increase your risk of COVID-19 and other respiratory infections, and getting both COVID-19 and influenza at the same time, which is a possibility, could be catastrophic. The best things you can do to reduce your risk of that occurring are maintaining your COVID-19 precautions of mask use, hand hygiene, and social distancing, and for influenza, getting your flu shot. The flu vaccine reduces your risk of influenza by 70%, and it's more important this year than ever. Number three, pandemic fatigue. The past 8 months have been difficult, and many people are experiencing fatigue, leading them to let their guard down. As we approach these winter months and we're seeing cases rising, it's more important than ever that we double down on these precautions and do everything that we can to continue responding to this threat. Since COVID arrived, experts have had their eyes on this time of year as possibly the greatest challenge we would face during this global pandemic. If we stay the course and focus on what we know works, masking, social distancing, and hand hygiene, we can get through this challenge together and move forward with care, not fear.